First of all, thank you for letting me do this remotely. I'm going to talk about the link between urbanization and women's lives. As we will see, it's a complex cause-effect relationship with urbanization affecting women's lives and women's choices affecting the development of urbanization. So let's see how it goes. Oh no, can you move? Yeah, so first because of general assumption on urbanization, we have a series of hypotheses about demographic trends. So we test these hypotheses through a particular methodology by calculating lifetime tables with mortar and with applying settlement scaling theory. And we are going to do this on two case studies, Central Italy and Germany. Yeah, in fact, the other thing I wanted to say is that I only signed myself for this conference, but really this work is done in collaboration with a German colleague, Niels Müller-Schessel. So I might be also speaking on his behalf. Can you move on slide? Okay, so the assumption we have is that normally we know that with urban environments there was lower hygienic condition and higher spread of disease. So according in relation to women lives, we might expect an increased maternal mortality. On the other hand, in urban environment, there is also greater productivity and available of better food. So we might also expect an increase in the duration of life. And also, I noticed that with urbanization, normally there is shorter breastfeeding time. I will see which consequences also this might have. As a caveat, I said at the end of this slide, I don't know if you can see, there is the problem of migration. So migration can change a lot of the demographics of urban and non-urban societies. But because I'm talking about the Iron Age, where mobility was relatively small, I'm not taking this factor into consideration for the moment. Can you move the slide? Okay, so these are some of the calculation we have used. So as I said, the calculation of life tables with death percentage, mortalities, life expectancy per age category. And this is the software developed by my colleague, the German colleague. Then we corrected life expectancy at birth according to the formula by Bucket, Appel, and Massad. You see in the screen, and my colleague would explain in more detail. But basically, is based, if I remember correctly, is partially based on the proportion of children between 5 and 15 years of age. It makes a particular calculation. Then there is also the calculation of maternal mortality according to the McFadden and Oxnam formula. Again, this one takes also into consideration the death of male and female. And finally, the total fertility rate after Bucket, Appel, and McFadden, Oxnam. Again, this one, I think, calculate a particular percentage of children below 5 years old and above 5 years old. And all these calculations have been implemented, as I said, through the Mortar software. Another slide. So general scholar who study urbanism, and in particular those who use settlement scaling theory, have observed some recurring regularities in urban society. So normally, more populous cities have less land per capita, while less populous cities have more land per capita. But more populous, more populous cities has less infrastructure per capita, produce more GDP, individuals have more collection, and there is more specialization of labor. This is the more populous cities. The less populous cities have more land per capita, more infrastructure per capita, but produce less. Individuals have less connection, and there is less specialization of labor. The next slide. So actually, all these things are not completely new. Human settlement are first and foremost concentration of human interaction. And given a set of energetic constraints imposed by technology and institution, people arrange themselves in space and create infrastructural networks so as to balance the cost of moving around with the benefits of the resulting interaction. So basically, the settlement scaling theory says that socioeconomic outputs are proportional to the social interaction that occur over a given period. As I said, this is not completely new. Other theorists had said this, but what settlement scaling theory does is that he has put it in quantitative reproducible experimental calculation. The next slide, unpredictable value. So we are going to consider two case studies. One is the very famous Osteria dell'Osa. People who are familiar with Mediterranean archaeology will probably know this site. It was a sort of competitor of Rome during the Iron Age, located on the Via Prenestina to the east of Rome. And here a necropolis has been found with about 600 tombs from the 10th to the 6th century before Christ. The next slide. Try again. Yeah, from north of the Alps, we have three case studies. In particular, I would like to point out Musingen Rain, which is one of the the Magdalenberg is one of the princely seats for, while the other two are two simple rural society. And we will see that it's not without consequences, probably, that Frustensitz behave a bit differently, because it's supposed to be a central place with greater productivity and greater social differentiation. The next slide. Okay, some data then. As we said, as we can see, both from the case of Osteria dell'Osa, for Osteria dell'Osa, 2A is the oldest phase, is the 9th century before Christ. 2B, 3A is the 8th century before Christ, and 3B, 4 is the 7th century of Christ. So as you can see, both for the Italian case study and the German case study, that there is generally an increased maternal mortality with the increased degree of urbanization. If we consider that urbanization increases between the 9th and the 7th century before Christ. Also, life expectancy at 20 years old generally increases. That is a bit less linear, but it seems to increase as well. The next slide. But I also try to make a difference between. Hello, mommy. I'm sto facendo una presentazione. So I try to calculate a specificity between male and female. And actually, as probably is expected, we know in the past it was different from modern time. The female seems to live a bit less, so that they their expectancy of life increases with urbanization, but is always a bit less than male. So the orange are the female and the blue are the male. Next slide. I calculated this only for Osteria Dell'Osa because it's something that I became more interested in more recent time, so I had no time. We had no time to do it for the German case study as well, but we might do it if there is a publication. Then, as I said, expectancy of life seems to be also directly correlated with projected GDP. And as you can see, there seems to be a steady growth of GDP in respect of expectancy of life, but you can see the, as I said, the Magdalenberg site is much more an outlier. And this, with my colleague, we thought this is probably because, as I said, this is a Fürstensitz site, so one of these rich princely sites. So it's the GDP is even more more pronounced. The next slide. I also tried to apply the settlement scaling theory. I wasn't so sure about this because I got a sort of inverse relationship. So I'm still thinking a little bit about this. But also what seems to be interesting is that to the southern of the Alp, the relationship is super linear, while, if I remember correctly, while at the north of the Alp is sublinear. And so that I was wondering if that might be for the different degree of urbanization, again, more developed in the south and less developed in the north. But I have to admit that this result of the settlement scaling theory were a bit uncertain for me. I might want to think a bit about them a bit more. Next slide. The duration of breastfeeding. Yes, so we haven't done isotopic analysis. I think someone else, maybe in fact from Terrenato group, is doing it, but based at least on the indication of mortality. If you see on the left, there is the graph of mortality of children in the different phases, and there seems to be a very high peak around 2-3 years of age. So that we might assume that might be the breastfeeding time, because we know that it was a very critical time and a lot of children died. So this is just an assumption, but if this is the case, this actually would be coherent with the decreased fertility that we can see in the graph. Now, this result actually goes not against, but a little bit in contrast with a general trend I observed in another study on all the Mediterranean population between prehistory and Middle Ages, which actually said that in urban society, women tend to breastfeed less and have more children. So why do we have this trend at Osteria Dell'Osa? We would expect the opposite, the fertility to increase with urbanization. So I gave myself two options. Either there is some problem with the data, because we know that actually the later sample for Osteria Dell'Osa is less numerous than the earlier sample, or, which is also actually very interesting, if you see the graph, the fertility seems to be increasing again in the 5th century with the Musinger site in Germany. So it could be that actually the peak of urbanization is really the 5th century before Christ, as all the scholars have often sustained. So actually the 8th century BC is only a qualitative leap forward, but actually the great change in mode of life and infrastructure and all the rest is in the 5th century. The next slide. So yeah, this is just to summarize it all. So as we expected, with poor hygienic condition, we might have increased maternal mortality, which we verified at Austria Dell'Osa and Germany. However, we had also greater expectancy of life, even if it was relatively lower for women. We also saw that greater expectancy of life was directly correlated with greater GDP. As we said, there seems to be a different relationship with settlement scaling theory between the community to the north and to the south of the Alps. And also, as I said, I cannot see my last conclusion because it's covered. Breastfeeding time seems to be longer at Austria Dell'Osa, which means lower fertility rates, but this might be because the real increase of urbanization, as I said, is the 5th century and not before. And last slide, I think, is my thank you. Yes, thank you very much. In this slide, I presented kind of two representative of this urban society. On the left, a typical rich female burial, and on the right, a warrior burial. Thank you very much for your attention.